Hello, today I will be showing you how to wake up a dormant lithium cell. There's a number of different lithium cells, such as one of your most common is the 18650 cell, which is a little bit bigger than a AA battery. And these are commonly found inside laptop batteries, certain rechargeable flashlights, cordless vacuum cleaners. List goes on and on. There's about 7,000 of these, actually more than 7,000 of these, inside a Tesla automobile. So that's one style. And then you have your more traditional flat style cell, which is commonly found in your cell phone. Now, basically, the lithium battery is a very volatile battery, and without proper battery management, they can be relatively dangerous as well. And the batteries actually have something inside it. It's actually a microchip that manages charging and voltages of the cell. And basically, those chips manage three main components, or main things. One is overvoltage, so if you charge the cell to a voltage too high and bring it into its danger zone. Undervoltage, and if the voltage drops too low, it will actually completely disable power flow. And temperature. And so what I'm going to basically show you how to do is wake up a cell phone battery, one that has gone into dormancy due to a low voltage. Now, the reason they have the low voltage cutout is because if the voltage gets too low on one of these cells, number one, it starts losing capacity, overall battery storage capacity. So the milliamp hours or watt hours, depending on how that manufacturer has rated that battery. Number two is if the voltage gets too low and you try recharging the battery, it can actually become dangerous and explode or start on fire. And most of the ones I have found cut out at about 2.9 volts, which is getting pretty darn close to the bad zone there. Now, if you purchased a battery, replacement battery online, or if you have multiple batteries for a cell phone. This one I'm just using an example. It's a fairly old, fairly worn out Sprint Sanyo. Sanyo 5500S. This is probably from, I want to say, 2002 or 2003. So this phone's about 10 years old. The original battery. This has been sitting in a drawer for a good, probably 6 or 7 years at minimum. Now, what happens is, and I've done this myself, is you have spare batteries for a phone. Well, you're not swapping your batteries out regularly, but you might keep one as a spare for travel and whatnot. And sitting in a drawer, battery might lose some voltage over time, and that emergency cutout mightn't act. And what that will do is it stops. Well, if you have this in a phone, it would stop the power from flowing out. It would stop that whatever device it's in from drawing any more power out of it. So I'll demonstrate here. Now, the terminals on this battery are labeled. So you got a positive, got a negative, and then the center one is actually the temperature sensor. So, as you can see on the multimeter, 0 volts. But it's not actually 0 volts. Like I said, once it gets to a certain voltage, it cuts all power to that battery. So, I don't deal with cell phone batteries very much, but I do deal with the 18650 style when rebuilding laptop battery packs. This battery pack actually had, 12 of these, 12 of the 18650s. So I do have an 18650 size charger. Unfortunately, it's not compatible terminal-wise for charging this lithium cell. but they're both pretty much the same chemistry. They both have the same charging voltages and cutout voltages. Now, one of these is considered dead. A lithium cell is considered dead when voltage is about 3.2 volts. And they're also considered full when the voltages are at approximately 4.2 volts. So just as an example, this 18650 is at 4.13 volts. So what I did is I had some spare multimeter leads from another project of mine. And I just connect, I use clothespins, you know, not the most scientific. I use clothespins to connect them up to the correct terminals. So nice thing about the this 18650 charger is it is microprocessor controlled, and it will stop at the maximum voltage, and it will adjust charging rates accordingly. So just to show you that that 18650 is on and working. Let's see, you should be able to see the little green light there. And I'm just going to use the leads I have here. This is positive and negative, just to show that power flow is not happening. It's, adjust my wires just a bit. Let's try again. Might have damaged one of my leads earlier. Actually, it might even it might be right in that one is full. Nope, those are rated as full. Well, let's just go ahead and try it anyways. I think those are all a little too high for it to start kicking in. So we put one on one, the positive on the positive mark terminal, and negative on the negative. There we go. Yeah, those are full. See, now the light has turned red, which means the battery is, in fact, accepting a charge. Okay. Now that we gave it a little bit of a charge, that battery management circuit should have woken up. And if you see the multimeter, we're at 3.16 volts. Now, and it's probably going to drop down. Since I only did that for a few seconds, that was probably just enough to get enough surface voltage in the battery to wake up that chip. Now, the reason why you might have to do it outside a phone instead of being able to put it in a phone, the problem I'm running into is the circuitry inside the phone, since the phone is also the charger, will not activate or turn the phone on to be able to charge the battery if the battery is below a certain voltage or what the phone considers dead. And that's done for a few reasons. And one is so they can make more money by selling you more expensive batteries. And I already know, because I've been playing with this one already, I woke this battery up and then I re-drained it after testing to make sure it was still a good battery. And I could at least demonstrate, because I'm running out of batteries to demonstrate with. So we're just going to hook this up again. And we're going to leave it on until that multimeter will show. We want that multimeter to show about 3.2 volts. Let's see if I can. I do have good chopstick skills, but. During charging, we're at 3.5. Take the charging leads off. A few more seconds. And we just need that surface voltage on the battery to stay above the 3.2. just long enough, or your mileage may vary depending on the phone, but in this phone it would be about 3.2 volts, just long enough to get it in the phone. And get it to start charging the battery. see if we can turn it on. Press the right button. There we go, powering up. And that's how you wake up a cell phone battery. I had one, we're on a fairly large family plan for a cell phone with U.S. Cellular. And we get free phones or discounted phones every 2 years for each one of the numbers. We have six lines with them on one large plan. Myself, a friend, my parents, and my grandparents. Well, my grandparents have had their phones for about 3 years, and they finally figured out how to use them. And, they're in their mid-80s, so, even the VCR is still a technological marvel for them. And I'm sure half the people watching this don't even know what a VCR is anymore. But they're definitely not going to be changing phones unless they're forced to. So every 2 years, it's either take it or lose it for our new phone. So we get our discounted phone, which is usually anywhere from a penny to about $15. Why not? If we don't take it, it's not like the clock's going to reset. We just lose out on 2 years worth of phones. So I get a stash of new phones that come up pretty quick. And I'm usually pretty good about plugging them in once every 4 or 5 months if we're not switching over. But just did one, open one up. We were running a little low. My dad goes through them like you can't believe. And we were just replacing another one that finally bit the dust. We're down to our last spare phone, new phone. Some of the older ones, not working the best. And it's been sitting in a box in the shelf for about a year now. And the battery went into dormant mode. Wouldn't charge it. So popped it out. It's almost like a jump start in a car. Only we use these tiny little jumper cables. And woke it up just enough to get the cell phone to start charging it. And within about 2 hours, the battery was full. And it had pretty much its original, it seemed to have lost a little bit of its original capacity, but not enough to make it worthwhile. And the nice thing is I was able to order a new battery for it off the internet for about $4. So I have kept this video going way longer than it should have. It's like midnight and brain's not going 100%, so hopefully that might save you a few bucks. Another way this is useful is, you lost or damaged your charger for your phone. You got to get some important numbers off of it. Now that everything's pretty much switching over to USB as the charging cable, it's not as imperative as it used to be. Proprietary cables like this one, they're mostly standardized now. But you can do that to charge up the phone. You're going to sit there for probably about 15 or 20 minutes charging that battery, but you can charge that battery up enough where you can at least get the phone on to stay on long enough to get your numbers off. It's always something good to do. Let's see, now I know that everybody's going to have an 18650 charger available. Let's see what happens. Could have not even just... See, now that one lights up. The world may never know. But if you don't have one of these nice chargers, you can get these at Deal Extreme, which is the letter D as in dog, X as in x-ray. dx.com. This lithium cell charger, and it does a number of different sizes of lithium batteries. Costs about $4, free shipping straight from Hong Kong. So even if you just have one, if you ever use anything with a 18650 cell, these are great for flashlights. I use mine, my new flashlight. This thing, this is bright. It's almost like a lightsaber out on a foggy day. Very, very bright. You can use a USB cable. If you have an old iPhone, old iPhone cable, you know, you upgraded your iPhone, you got the old style plug, or you have any other kind of USB cable that you don't need anymore, it's junk, the old fat style plugs on them from the 90s, you can cut the end off, separate the wires out, and make sure none of the wires are touching each other, plug it into a computer, and use your multimeter to find which wires are positive and which are negative, and you can actually use those positive and negative wires to jump start your battery. The amperage might not be as high, but USB is rated at about 5 volts, so it should be just fine for jump starting a battery and getting it woken up and being able to charge it on the phone itself. And that covers it. I'm going to stop rambling. Have a great night and see you next video.